We are back on Inside Politics. Our guest today, Professor Thomas Swartz from Vanderbilt University. He's a presidential scholar. We're talking about the presidency of John Kennedy as we are not far from the 43rd anniversary of his assassination. Professor, the way the president died and the controversy that has raised over the past half century or more, did it mark really an end of an age of innocence in America? I know for those of us who were younger, certainly it did, but even for our parents, was that the beginning when they weren't quite sure over the years as they went forward that the government told them the truth about all this?
It did, although in order to understand it, you have to see it in context, that the assassination took place, there was the Warren Commission, there was the attempt to explain it as the work of one assassin, but all of this was coinciding with the developing war in Southeast Asia, in Vietnam, in which, in a way, was also producing disillusionment, and then you have the ongoing impact of the sense that the government is being deceptive there.
And you had Watergate.
And you had Watergate. So you had a cascading sense of the government is not being as trusted or as reliable as I think people in the late 1940s and 50s did feel after coming out of World War II, where the government had, in effect, launched a world war, won that war, and brought about the peace. And I think that had given it enormous credibility that was then lost.
There's probably been few events in American history that have spawned as many conspiracy theories as the Kennedy assassination. Has that been true with other presidential assassinations, Lincoln, Garfield, McKinley?
The Lincoln assassination was indeed a conspiracy. John Wilkes Booth was trying
to
recruit.
They tried to kill a
number of people in the cabinet, so that there was indeed a conspiracy. The other two assassinations were the work of lone gunmen, although for political motives, they didn't have the conspiratorial element to it. But the Lincoln assassination and all the parallels between Lincoln and Kennedy. Remember that in 1963, we were going through a period where we were talking about the 100th anniversary of various Civil War elements. And the idea that this was connected, I think, was very much in people's minds.
Has the rise of social media and the internet made all this stuff about conspiracy theories even more embedded and continued to grow? Because you certainly didn't have that in Lincoln's days, but certainly that was done through a lot of the newspapers. But
right.
There's a lot more fertile atmosphere to do that.
Even before social media, I mean, the sense that the Kennedy assassination, the problem was, the simple fact was that people had a hard time equating Lee Harvey Oswald, who seemed like a relatively obscure, unimportant figure, with the death of this significant American president. And that the balance did not seem to make sense to people. They looked for a conspiracy, and that conspiracy was there even before social media, before all those things, that belief that something, there had to be some larger purpose, some larger goal in the assassination.
So are you one of those who believe that Lee Harvey Oswald was acting as a lone wolf, a lone gunman on this, or do you believe there was a conspiracy he had other hands?
I think he was acting as a lone gunman, but I think what I think the Warren Commission did a poor job of was trying to look at the motivations behind it. And one of the reasons they did that is they were trying to conceal, various government agencies were trying to conceal some of the other things that were going on at the time, such as our attempts to kill Fidel Castro. And I think if that had been more widely known or come to be known, it might have been clearer why a political radical like Oswald might have actually thought, well, they're trying to kill Castro, I'm going to kill Kennedy.
Some might say that continues to be sort of the cover up that's continuing today, the remaining documents that had never been released about the Kennedy assassination that the government had, that the government archives have, were supposed to all been released earlier this year. Mm-hmm. But at the last minute, President Trump, at the request of some of the intelligence agencies, decided not to release all of them. Doesn't that just further more conspiracy theories and websites to talk about
that? It furthers conspiracy theories, but if you actually look at the documents that were released, you realize that many of them had little to do with the Kennedy assassination. Some of them had to do with FBI surveillance of other figures. These documents don't necessarily mean that there's any sort of great smoking gun or anything in there, but it certainly did fuel that.
Now, one thing that came out just in recent days was a story about an FBI informant who's apparently working with Jack Ruby, who later assassinated Oswald. On the day President Kennedy came to Dallas on that Friday, mm-hmm. he was talking to this informant and said, hey, you need to come down to me. And he did come down to the presidential motorcade and said, come down and see the parade and see the fireworks. Well, now, how would Jack Ruby know there were going to be fireworks? And is fireworks something else to mean, like shooting?
My own thought on that, both from reading extensively about Oswald and Ruby and the rest, is that Ruby was using an expression for what would be the celebration in Nashville of the president's arrival, the motorcade, all the rest. I don't think, even though I'm sure the choice of words would lead people to think otherwise, I don't think that he meant the assassination. In fact, from what we know from other people who interacted with Ruby, he was terrifically shocked by the assassination. He liked President Kennedy a great deal, and one of the reasons he shot Oswald was his hatred of Oswald for having killed President Kennedy.
The Jack Ruby connection made a lot thinking that organized crime or the mob had something to do with it, but you don't think that's the case?
I don't, although I do understand why that particular element has developed, both because of Ruby's somewhat shadowy connections to criminal elements, but also because organized crime or the mob was used by the Kennedy administration and even earlier to try and go after Castro. And so the idea that the mob was being used as a sort of tool of the government was certainly there.
Lee Harvey Oswald went to Russia. He went to Cuba.
A lot of people didn't. He went to Mexico.
He went to the Cuban embassy in Mexico.
He went to the Cuban embassy, yes, that's right.
So he did have some ties to those countries. There's people who tried to tie it further into that, and it had something to do with that. You don't think there's anything there?
I think he did. What we do know is he certainly tried to go back. He was trying to get a visa to go back to Russia. He was also trying to get into Cuba at the time because he was, one thing we do know, even though his radicalism was not terribly well thought out, is that he was a political radical and a Marxist, or had fancied himself a Marxist revolutionary, and thought that Cuba, going to Cuba, he could assist the revolution there. So he was trying to do those things, but it seems like the Russians, from what we know of KGB files, really distanced themselves from him.
The assassination of President Kennedy was 54 years ago. Every year since that, the Gallup poll has measured what people think about whether there was a conspiracy involved. Right. That number of people who say yes has never gone below 50%. It's been as high as 76% back in the late 70s when I think there was a Senate investigation going on. Why does it persist among the public that they don't believe the lone gunman theory?
I think it's just very hard to accept that so much of history could be changed by one disgruntled man who was able to, because the security was a lot different then. There had not been an assassination for some 60 years. People, a successful assassination. The atmosphere at the time was such that the sense that Kennedy's assassination was an important turning point in American history, which has grown over the years, that has made people find it very hard to believe it could have been done by just one person.
Dr. Thomas Swartz, professor of history at Vanderbilt University and a presidential scholar, we're talking about President Kennedy's presidency and his tragic assassination in late November 1963, 54 years ago. Back to continue our conversation after you watch these messages.